गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वी आर लर्निंग सब्जेक्ट मशीन लर्निंग 3170724। इन दैट वी वांट टू लर्न हाउ प्रैक्टिकली वी कैन इंप्लीमेंट क्लासिफिकेशन एंड रिग्रेशन, बट टुडे वी विल सी क्लासिफिकेशन। सो फॉर दैट लेट अस हैव द प्रोग्राम। दिस वी आर यूजिंग कॉलर, राइट? एंड what we'll be using here, that is we can say fruit data dot txt, right? Okay, so let us first consider the fruit data. Just a second. From where we have taken that data, that is from this one, right? This link is there from which we have taken the data. Let me open that and show you. Here is the fruit data. Oh, just a second. Yeah, so now you can see that. Okay, this is our collab program. Where is our text file? That is available here, right? The link from which we are taking the file, that's what I have opened here. Now what we want to have this fruit file, right? So let me copy this here and let me make one file here on the current folder, that is we can say I am creating a text file. Fruit data, same file, okay? Fruit data dot txt. So I'm just pasting the content. So we'll be able to see. I can show you the file here. Where is the file? File. Machine learning. Okay. Fruitdata.txt. The file which we have put here is available here. Fine. You can see the content. Now, here. fruitdata.txt. As the file is locally available, we have to upload it on the collab, then only we'll be able to use it. So we are using, as you already know, from google.collab import files, f is equal to files.upload, right? This is known to us. So we'll be able to upload the file. Yeah, it is asking for file. I'm giving the file. It is being uploaded. Fine. Now, what do we want? We want to read the table, right? We want to read the table which is there in this particular file. So we are using pd.read_table. We already know that we can use pd.read_csv, or we can say txt or read_table, right? All these things we can read. Fine. For that, we are importing pandas as pd and matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Why are we importing this? That is, as we want to draw the graph for that, right? We want to have the plot. From the plot, we can get the visualization of particular data, right? So for that, what do we say is, first of all, we are reading this file, that is using fruits is equal to pd.read_table. This is not comma separated values, right? So we'll not use it as read_csv, but we are using it as read_table. Fine. Okay. So txt file we have provided. Now we want to see first five lines of the data so we can have the idea what are the column names or what sort of data is there, right? So for that we are using fruits.head. So it will print first 5 lines of our data, right? So we can see that here, what are the columns? Fruit label, fruit name, fruit subtype, mass, weight, height, color, score, right? This is what is available here, fine. This is what is available here, color underscore score, fine. Now, fruit name we can say, label is one, fruit is apple, fruit type is grainy underscore smith, mass is 192, width is 8.4, height is 7.3, and color score is 0.55, right? What it gives us, we can have the idea that this is numeric field. This is, we can say, string field. This is, what is that? This is also string. This is numeric. This is numeric, but it is real. That is float, we can say. This is also float, and this is also float, right? From whatever data set is given to us, we should first know the type of our data, whatever is given to us, isn't it? So now, what we are doing is, we want to have, say, mapping. What sort of mapping? That is, fruit label value to fruit name. So, it will be easier for us to interpret. Okay. So, what we are doing for that, we are using zip. We are using zip fruits dot fruit underscore label dot unique. We want to have the unique names, okay? We do not want to have all the names. Unique names, so that we can have the idea that this is the name and this is the number, right? So for label, what we are having it? It is 1, 2, 3, 4 we can expect, right? If we see the whole data, we can have the idea. So here what we are doing is label dot unique. So it will be taking unique values from this column. So 1, 2, 3, 4 will be able to get. And then after we can say that fruits dot fruit underscore name dot unique. So what it will give us? That is apple, mandarin, we can say orange, lemon, right? Whatever is unique in data that will be given to us, right? So what we are doing is that we are making zip where we can say that unique ID of label, then, and what is the next value? That is, we can say that is the name, right? So we are making zip of it, and with that, we are creating the dictionary, right? With that, we are creating the dictionary. So we'll be having 1 colon apple, 2 colon mandarin, 3 colon orange, and 4 colon lemon, right? It makes our life easier, isn't it? Now let us see fruits dot shape. What is fruits? What is fruits? That is the, what we can say is data frame, which we are typically used to have. It is DF. Here we have provided the name as fruits. That is a data frame. Now, fruits dot shape. For that, we can say that 59 rows, 7 columns. Okay. Now, what do we want to have is split the data into training and testing. See, now recall, we have learned that we are having the data set. What we do with that? We divide that in 2 parts, that is training data and testing data. Typically, we used to have, say, 70 to 80% of data we are giving to training, and remaining one we are keeping for the testing data, isn't it? So that's what we want to do. And for that, what we are doing is capital X, that is equal to fruits of. We know that we cannot provide this as a list only. We have to write it inside the list, isn't it? That is what is already known to you. So here we are providing the column names. So what is that? Mass, width, height, color underscore score. Why are we taking this only? Shouldn't we take anything else? We are taking this because this data is numeric data. And typically, as we know, that for machine learning algorithms, we need to have the numeric data that we have learned in prepare to model topic also, right? Okay, so we are preparing our model, isn't it? Thereafter will apply, but for that, for training data and testing data, what we are doing is x is equal to fruits and we are providing numeric data, right? Numeric data, that means the label we are giving, it will be taking the value, right? Y is equal to fruits of fruit label. What is fruit label? Fruit label is 1, 2, 3 or 4, right? This is what is there with us. This is our fruit label, which we are storing in Y, which we want to predict, right? Okay. So, here you can see this is capital X, this is small y. You already know, typically we are using for machine learning that X, whatever we are giving is typically there in capital X and Y is in small, right? We are not keeping it as capital Y. It is not mandatory, but this is a tradition, isn't it? Okay. So, when we do this, we'll see what is X. We are having the number data, fine. Then what is Y? That is also number data. This is fruit level, isn't it? What is the D type of it? That is int 64. That is of label. And what about this? All these are also numeric, isn't it? But. As we are having 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 columns, it is not giving us whether it is int 64 or you can say float 64, because here this is int. This is float. This is float. This is float. Right? So it is different, isn't it? Only one column is there, it can definitely give the type of it, isn't it? Okay, so here numeric data is there, integer, and we can say float is there. Fine. And this is the label. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now, what we want to do is import NumPy as NP, because we will need to have the NumPy arrays. Import pandas as PD. You can say that you have already imported. Yes, we have imported, but many a times people forget to include that. So that you can put here. Import matplotlib dot pyplot as plt, because we want to make the graph of it, from sklearn dot model underscore selection, import train underscore test underscore split. We want to split the data into training data and testing data, right? So for that, we are importing this. As we already know that for machine learning algorithms, we are using sklearn library, isn't it? So that's what we are importing here. From sklearn.model underscore selection, import train underscore test underscore split. Fine? Okay. So we should include that. Now, divide the data in training and testing data. So how we can do that? We can use this particular function, that is train underscore test underscore split. Train underscore test underscore split. Okay, so do not forget that. Now, for that, what we'll be getting is x underscore train, comma, x underscore test, comma, y underscore train, comma, y underscore test. We are having two coordinates, what we have considered, capital X and small y, right? So for that, we need to have x underscore train, y underscore train, x underscore test, and y underscore test, right? This is what we want to have. So this four coordinates we have written here, that is equal to, by doing this split operation, that is using, we can say train underscore test underscore split, will be getting the result, isn't it? So for that, the parameters are test size, we can say train size. Test size is typically there in, you can say 25%, 20 to 25% we are having. For train size, we can say we are having 70 to 80%, right? So that is that. We can say random state. What do we mean by that? Is if integer random state is the seed used by the random number generator. And what we say is, if none, then the random number generator is the random state instance used by np.random. Okay. So then after what? Shuffle. Shuffle is Boolean. It is optional, but default value is true. Stratify. Stratified option we have already seen, right? For replacement, we can say, what you can say that random samples by replacement, there we have considered it stratified, right? Okay, so that concept we are using here. Default is none, right? Default is none. If not none, data is split in a stratified fashion. Okay, so now let us see the parameters so we can understand this. This parameters we have seen. Now see the parameters value. Okay, let us see that so we can have the idea. What we are specifying here is train underscore test underscore split, the function which will divide the data set into two parts, that is training data and testing data, where we are providing capital X and small y. Then random state, it is equal to zero, right? Okay, so now let us say what we are doing. We are plotting a scatter matrix. So how we do that? For that, we can say from matplotlib import cm. Cmap, we want to see the cmap, or you can say scatter matrix for our data, right? So how we are getting it? Cm dot get underscore cmap gnuplot. For drawing the plots, we are using the gnuplot. Okay. For MATLAB also, internal library is of gnuplot. So that's what we are using here. Scatter is equal to pd dot plotting dot scatter underscore matrix. We do not only want to have the scatter plot for a particular data. That is, you can say x and y is given, and you can say you are having one scatter plot. Here we do not want to have that. Here we want to plot a scatter matrix. Okay, so for that we can say we'll be using PD. PD is our pandas, right? Pandas dot plotting. In that we are having what we can see here. PD dot plotting. So for that we can say plotting public API is there. What we can do is we can use line, bar, you can say bar edge, box, hist, KDE, area, pi, scatter, hex bin, all these things we can draw with what? That is PD dot plotting, right? Okay, many other things are there. We want to use this scatter matrix, fine? So PD dot plotting dot scatter underscore matrix. There, now what we provide is X underscore train, C is equal to Y underscore train, marker is equal to O, that is you can say circle we want to see for the scatter, then we can say we are providing s is equal to 40 and hist underscore kwd s, that is we want to provide the histogram beans, right? So that is equal to beans and colon 15, right? So now what we are doing is we will be able to see the scatter matrix. We can see the scatter matrix. We are able to see the histogram also. Fine. Now what is that? Here, here we are having mass. Here we are having width. Here we are having height. And here we are having color. Here, this particular scatter plot is there for color underscore score mass. Here we can say it is color underscore score width. Here we are having color underscore score and height. And here we are having the histogram. Okay. So you can understand that the names are written on y-axis also as well as x-axis also. Here we are able to see whole scatter matrix. Fine. Whole scatter matrix. So we can have the idea how the data is there. From the visualization, we can understand it very easily, right? From the visualization, we can understand it very easily. Otherwise, it will be difficult to understand the data from text data or you can say Excel data or whatever it may be. You see only the numbers, so you cannot interpret it. But if we are having visualization, we can interpret it very easily, isn't it? Here you can say that this two candida outlier. From the way the data is there, typically the data is here only, but this one we can say it can be the outlier because it is too far away from the normal behavior of the data, isn't it? So that's what we can have the idea about our data, right? For that we are having the scatter matrix, right? Now KNN classification algorithm, that is we can say it is called K nearest neighbor classification algorithm. Okay. Now, how we can use it here? That is, we can say from sklearn.neighbors import K neighbors classifier. We have to import K neighbors classifier. Now, what we want is, this is we have imported only. Now we should make the object of it. That is, KNN is equal to, say, K neighbors classifier, N underscore neighbors is equal to 5. We are going to consider 5 neighbors only for this particular algorithm. Okay. Now, typically, what is the case? As we have considered training data and testing data, right? We should first of all train our model and then after we should test it, isn't it? So, and then after we'll do the prediction. This is what we are doing typically, isn't it? So, for that, we can say we should first of all do fit for, we can say training data, that is for training the model, we are using the method that is fit. We mean to say that fit the model with this training data, right? Fit the model with the training data. That is what we can do with fit method for that particular classifier's object. So knn.fit x underscore train and y underscore train. With the training data, we are training the model, right? So when we do that, what will be getting with that, we can say we'll be having the K neighbors classifier algorithm is automatically it is selected and run, no manual or interaction is there. The size is 30. Then we can say metric is equal to Minkowski, that is we can say that the distance, right? For finding the neighbor, who are the neighbors to me? So for that, the distance is being used, and that we can say is the Minkowski. Metric parameters, none. N underscore jobs, that means how many jobs we want to specify for this training, that is equal to none. N underscore neighbors is 5. Weights is equal to uniform. We are not giving separate weights to any particular data. We are giving weights uniform, right? So now, after we have trained the model, now what we are doing is, we are finding the score. What is the score? That is the estimate, the accuracy of the classifier on future data using the test data, right? So for that, we can say knn.score. Score, right? It returns the accuracy of the given test data and levels, right? So for that, we can say knn.score x underscore test and y underscore test. So what it will do is, it will find the accuracy of the classifier. Let us see that. Okay, this is the classifier accuracy. Okay. Now, what do we want is, use the trained KNN classifier model to classify new, previously unseen object. So typically what we used to do is, for classification, we are having the data with the class labels, right? This is what is available to us. What we do to prepare the model, we are dividing the data set into two parts, that is training data and test data. Then after, we train the model with the training data. After that, we test the model using the test data. After that, we provide the unknown data for which it will predict, right? For unknown data, the model will predict what should be the value, right? Now here, what are we predicting? That is the fruit label, isn't it? From whatever are the characteristics. What are the characteristics we have choose for, we can say that for training the data? That was the capital X. Right? For capital X, we can say that we have considered, let me show you, it was mass, width, height, and color underscore score. Remember that we have considered capital X is equal to this one, right? Where we have considered the column of mass, width, height, and color underscore score. Fine? So, that's what we want to use for prediction, fine? So for unknown value of this columns, we'll be giving, and we want to predict that which is the fruit. That is the fruit label we want to get. So for that, fruit underscore prediction is equal to KNN. What is KNN? That is our data frame option, right? Is it data frame object? It is the classifier object, right? It is not called the data frame object. It is called the what? It is called the classifier object, right? Okay. So, knn.predict, and we are providing the data. Now, here also, please see it properly. It is not a single square bracket inside that a list is there? No, it is not the it is not so. We are having two square brackets, right? Inside the parenthesis. That is predict is there. Then after these parenthesis, that is for the function. Then after you can say we want to provide a list. But that you cannot directly provide. You need to provide this way, that is square bracket. Inside that we have to provide the list, right? And list is always there in the square bracket. This is known to us, isn't it? I'm just trying to get your attention for this particular thing. Okay, fine. So now with this, we are predicting. So what will be getting? If we want to get the label, that will be there in first column. That is, you can say zeroth column, right? Or you can say for this list, we are having at zero the fruit label. Okay, let me show you that. For this particular value, that is the mass is 20, width is 4.3, height is 5.5, and color underscore score is 0.8, right? If this is the value, we can say the prediction of this particular fruit is mandarin. Okay, so what we have done, let me tell you as a summary, you can have the idea. First of all, we have read the data set. Fine, this is typical. Yeah, you can say uploaded also, right? But that's okay, you have uploaded, the data set is available. Fine, read the data set. Then after, we have split the data set in two parts, that is training data and testing data, isn't it? This is what we have done. Typically for training data, we know that we are using 70 to 80% of data typically, okay? It is not specific. When we are saying typically or generally, you can understand that in most of the cases, people are using it, right? Okay, so here we can say it is 20 to 30% for testing data. That is what we have split. Then after, we have this is what we are doing with what? Train underscore test underscore split, right? Then after, what we need to do is we need to train the model. Train the model, that is using what? That is using the fit method, right? After that, what we are doing is we are testing, or you can say that we are finding the accuracy of the model using the what? Test data, right? Using the test data, accuracy score using the test data. This is what we are finding. After that, what we are doing is, after that, we will be doing the prediction. How we can do the prediction? We have to provide the data, right? We have to provide capital X data. That is, you can say here we have considered mass, weight, height, and color underscore score. So that's what we are providing the value, and we can do predict. That is, prediction is done using the predict method, isn't it? That is using the predict method. So we'll be getting the prediction. Fine. We'll be getting the prediction. Then what? We are getting the value, right? But how are we getting the value? We are getting the value with this fruit underscore prediction zero, right? Look up fruit name. Why are we using? That is the dictionary we are having. In that, we are providing the index. We want to provide the index, right? What we get here that we are providing. So from that, the key is being provided to this dictionary and we'll be getting the value, isn't it? So that's what we are doing. We are predicting and getting from the dictionary as we have stored in the dictionary, right? Okay, let me show one more thing. That is, what is there in this fruit underscore prediction, this variable, for which we have considered this zero. And then after, we can say we have taken that value from the dictionary. That is, for this particular key, what is the value? That is what we have found from this statement, isn't it? So let us see what is there in fruit underscore prediction. That is, what is the result of knn.predict, right? Let's see that. It says array 2, right? It says array 2, fine. And what we get, if I print it as prediction 0, prediction 1 and 2. It says index 1 is out of bounds, right? So what we need to do is we just have to get 1, Fine. So now what we are getting is 2, right? What we are getting is 2. This index where we have printed this fruit underscore prediction, right? This is what we have already printed. Let me show this. Okay. This 2 only we want to get. So what we have done is we have used this one, that is this of 0, right? There only we are getting the value, isn't it? And that we have provided to the dictionary which we have created, lookup underscore fruit name. From that we are getting what is the fruit name, isn't it? And that is, we can see we are getting with this. Fine. So this is the KNN classifier using Python. And which library we have used? That is the SKLearn library. Fine. We have used the SKLearn library. This is the typical working of any particular classification algorithm. Fine. We have to train it. Yeah. Before using FIT, what we can say is in the program step, we can say this is the typical step, but for say SQLearn library, then we can say that we have to make the classifier object, isn't it? Which is available in the SQLearn library. Okay. So this is a simple thing with which we can have any classification algorithm we can apply on our data. And the typical flow is, have the training and test data, then we can train the model, then we can say test the model, and then after we can say that we are predicting. Okay. So let us give some other value for say mass, weight, height, and color underscore score. I am giving some other value. Fine. For that, what is the output? That is lemon, right? For that, we are getting lemon, isn't it? Now, what we do? We want to know how sensitive is KNN classification accuracy to the choice of the K parameter. K parameter, right? For that, we want to know that how sensitive KNN classification accuracy. See, we know that for any classification, we are using accuracy, then after what we can say, sensitivity, specificity, error underscore rate, all these parameters we use for algorithm measures, isn't it? Which algorithm measures? Classification algorithm measures, or we can say performance measures, we can say, right? So we are using classification, error rate, sensitivity, specificity, then we can say F measure and many other, isn't it? So we want to check it out that how sensitive is KNN classification accuracy according to K, what we are choosing. Fine. Now, what is that K? That K is N underscore neighbors is equal to K. How many neighbors we are choosing? That is the K for this KNN algorithm. So what we are doing here, say K underscore range is equal to range 1 to 20. We are checking for the range of 1 to 20, right? That what is the accuracy score, fine? So what we do is for scores is equal to array, sorry, not array. It is our list, empty list, okay? We'll be adding the scores, that is the accuracy for, you can say, different case. Right, let me show you that. For K in K underscore range, for K in K underscore range, that is, you can say that we are having the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 19, isn't it? So for different range of K, for different K, we are running this classification algorithm and whatever is the score, that is the accuracy score that we are storing in this particular list. We want to see how sensitive this algorithm according to the choice of key, right? Okay, so for that simple thing, what we are doing is knn is equal to k neighbors classifier, n underscore neighbors is equal to k, whatever k we are providing from here. We need to train the model. See, whole algorithm now we are running here, right? That is knn.fit. We are training the data. We are training the data. No, we are training the model with the data. Okay. We are training the model with the data, and that is x underscore train and y underscore train. We are not changing our train and test data. We are only changing the k, that is the n underscore neighbors. Fine. So now to train the data, we know that we have to use the method, that is fit method. knn.fit, x underscore train and y underscore train. Fine. Then after, what we do is we are finding the score, that is using knn.score, x underscore test and y underscore test. Whatever is the result of this, that we are storing in the scores.append, that is scores list. In that we are storing the result. Fine. Then after, we are having plot.figure. We want to plot it. That is, we can say we want to have the scatter plot. Now here we are not drawing the scatter matrix, but we are drawing the scatter plot. That is with the help of PLT, that is matplotlib.pyplot as PLT. That is what we have already imported. With that, first of all, we are having plt.figure. So we can say that figure is being made, prepared, right? Basic plt.xlabel. That is k. plt.ylabel is accuracy. We want to have the graph, that is, we can say that accuracy versus k, isn't it? plt.scatter. We want to draw the scatter plot. This is for k underscore range and this is for scores, right? plt.xticks. What we want to see on the x-axis, that is, you can say distances and the numbers which we want to see on the x-axis, that is, we can say as the x-ticks, isn't it? So now what we are doing is for the range of k from 1 to 19, we are running this algorithm and storing the accuracy in one list, and after that we are plotting the scatter plot, right? Let us run this and check it out. So what we can say, for one, it is somewhere here. For, you can say from 1 to 5, we can say here, it is having almost same value, right? Here it is having almost same value, not for 1, but from 2 to 5, we can say it is having almost same value. Then for this one, you can see it is again at this level. Then for this two, it is having same value, right? Can we say that as the value of k is increasing, the accuracy is decreasing? Can we say that? Obviously, yes, you can see that. See, here the k is 1. We can see it here. The k is increasing, not for this particular point, but still we can say that for almost all the other points, we can say that as the k is increasing, the accuracy is decreasing, isn't it? So that we can predict as, or you can say that we can visualize, isn't it? That we can visualize, isn't it? Now, what we want to know is how sensitive is knn classification accuracy to the train and test split proportion. What we have done before, there we have specified what What was our train underscore size? What was that? For our train underscore test underscore split, what we can say? What was the default size? We can see it here. By default, it is set to 0.25. That is for what? That is for the test underscore size. And for train underscore size, it is 75%, isn't it? So, by default, it is so, isn't it? Now, what we are doing is, if we change that, then what will be the effect on the accuracy score? That's what we want to know, right? So, now here we are giving it as training size that is equal to, we can say 0.8, 0.7, 0.6, 0.5, 0.4, 0.3, 0.2. For all of this, we want to know, right? KNN is equal to KNN, K neighbors classifier, and neighbors is equal to 5. Now we are fixing the neighbors. We are changing the training testing size. This split we are changing, right? We are having plt.figure, so we'll be able to draw the plots. Fine. Now what we are doing is, for S in T, we are taking one by one value. Now, for I in range of 1 to 1000, what we do is x underscore train, x underscore test, y underscore train, y underscore test, train underscore test underscore split. Now we are providing x, y. S size is equal to 1 minus s. What we have provided here, that was the training size. This was the training size we have specified, right? That is 80%, 70%, 60, 50, right? That way we have given. Here what we are doing is, we are providing the test size that is equal to 1 minus s, right? Now, knn.fit. So, we are training the model. This is what we are splitting. This is we are training. Then after, scores.append. How we are appending that? That is by finding the score of our model using the test data, isn't it? So knn.score, we are providing the data, that is text data, test of x data and test of y data, isn't it? Test data we are providing. And after that, what we do is, for this, we are having plt.plot s, comma, np.mean scores and bo. Right? What we are having is, we are having the blue and circle, right? With that, we want to plot, isn't it? After that, what we are doing is, we are setting the X label and Y label. For X label, what we are setting is training set proportion in percentage, and for PLT dot Y label, that is for Y axis, we are giving the accuracy. Fine. So let me run this. It will take some time. For each and every training, right, it is considering different size of train and test split, right? Then it is training the model, it is finding the score with the test data, and it is plotting the graph. This is what it is doing, right? And as we have done all these things in a loop, you can say after that we are giving this label, right? So what we can say is, we'll be able to see the plot. Here we can see, what is that? Training set proportion. This is 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8. As it is increasing, we can say that accuracy is getting increased, isn't it? Training set proportion is increasing, so we are getting accuracy also is increasing. Fine. So that's all for today.